Now the presidential address, I must be very, very brief. I don't like to take much of your time. Respected elders of the communist and left movements of our country who are present here, our leaders of the fraternal left parties who are present here in this Congress and sitting on the dais, our guests who have been invited to remain present in this inaugural session from Hyderabad cities and its nearby areas, mothers and sisters, brothers and friends, and of course our delegates and observers. At the outset, I would like to thank and express our gratitude to the people of Telangana who have extended their wholehearted support to organize our party congress in this historic city of Hyderabad. It is the constitutional mandate of our party that after every 3 years we have to organize our party congress. Accordingly, after Vizag, we are meeting here for our 22nd congress. What I very humbly would like to say that because of party constitutional mandate, no doubt, party congress is very important event in our party life. But this party congress is especially very important for us because country is now standing in a crossroad due to the policies being pursued for last 4 years by the government at the center, led by BJP and dictated, rather, I should say, controlled by RSS, a fascist organization, in its approach and activities since its inception, which had no role in the freedom struggle of our country. Politically, ideologically, and on the question of economic program and policies, this government is anti-people, out and out, pro-rich, and thoroughly reactionary, which the country has not seen since independence. This government has been pursuing the very obnoxious policy of divide and rule, destroying our cherished cultural ethos of secularism, blamelessly attacking our democracy, and acting as junior partner of US imperialism. Other than working class, working people, peasantry, agricultural workers, students, youth, women, especially the Muslim minorities and Dalits are under severe attack. This situation cannot be tolerated and allowed to continue. Therefore, it is the prime and urgent task to mobilize the people of all walks of life to counter these all-out attacks and ensure crushing defeat of these forces as early as possible. For the sake and greater interest of the country and its people, here, at this juncture, lies the importance of our party congress. Why I am saying so? Despite the fact that the left are not that strong, considering their strength and existence in this vast country, but still, the importance of the left cannot be ignored. The role of the left in organizing the class struggles, mass movements of our country, which certainly play a positive role in influencing the political atmosphere of the country, is a proven fact. Keeping this in mind, as a humble but important contingent of the left forces in India, the Communist Party of India Marxist has to evolve a proper political tactical line to be pursued in the coming days rigorously to fulfill the desire and aspiration of the common people of our country. To isolate and ensure defeat of the BJP-RSS combined. But obviously this has to be done without compromising our principled position as well as class and social outlook. Particularly, working class, working people, peasantry, secular-minded, democratic-minded, and patriotic people as a whole are anxiously waiting to see the outcome of our party congress. In this backdrop, I do hope that the delegates and observers who have assembled in this congress would certainly play their due role, which certainly help further to flourish class struggles and mass movement to meet the immediate political requirement. At the same time, this should help to advance the party to develop and strengthen the left democratic front, which will be the real and popular front of the people of India in true sense. We earnestly seek blessings and active support of the people of India in our honest and sincere endeavor for the betterment of the people of India and real advance of our beloved country, India. With this, I conclude. Thank you all.